Because coding interviews are not like the coding we do in our daily work, many of us are guilty of neglecting problem solving until the start of the interview process, giving us a week to prepare. But fear not, we'll discuss how we can prepare for this interview in 1 week using ChatGPT. ChatGPT will create a personalized study plan, explain different concepts, and solve practice questions together. By the end of the video, you will have a 1 week study plan, learning resources, and tons of practice questions with their answers and explanations for free without any subscriptions. So let's dive in. Let's ask ChatGPT to create a 1 week study plan to prepare for our coding interview. I am going to write the following. I want to prepare for a problem-solving coding interview in 1 week. The interview will have data structures and algorithms coding questions similar to the questions on HackerRank or LeetCode. I will use Python as my main programming language. Create a study plan that will help me prepare for this interview. This study plan should be focused on practice questions. In the prompt, I specified what I want to learn, my time frame, and the programming language I want to use. I also highlighted the practice questions are very important to me. Doing practice questions is crucial in acing your interview. A good study plan and explanation of concepts is good, but unless you practice what you've learned over many interview questions, you won't be able to answer questions easily in interviews. We will use ChatGPT to create a lot of practice questions with their answers and explanations later in the video. ChatGPT provided a day-by-day plan that takes you from the very beginning to advanced concepts. Day 1 is a review of the basics, like reviewing Python syntax, data types, data structures, strings, arrays, and sorting. Then it tells you to tackle some easy to medium level questions on the HackerRank or LeetCode. We'll ask ChatGPT to provide practice questions, so don't worry about creating a subscription. Day 2 is going to be focused on more advanced data structures, like linked lists, stacks, queues, and graphs. We also look at how they are implemented in Python, so we can utilize them when needed. And it tells you to do some more practice questions. Day 3 is going to be focused on different sorting algorithms. Day 4 is going to be more advanced techniques like dynamic programming. Day 5 is going to be about recursion, divide and conquer, and greedy algorithms. I would swap day 4 and day 5 with each other, since dynamic programming is an addition to the concepts in day 4 to make the code run faster. Day 6 is going to be for reviews and doing mock interviews and doing more practice questions. Day 7 is going to be more practice questions. I love how it allocates a good amount of time for practice. Let's now start studying. I will start off by refreshing my memory on the basics, followed by a lot of practice questions. I will write, act as a teacher and explain all content for day 1, provide code samples when possible. ChatGPT didn't waste time at all and started reviewing the Python syntax, followed by the data types. It covered integers, floats, strings, booleans, lists, and dictionaries. It also provided code samples for each. Then it showed you 2 simple practice questions and their answers to get you warmed up. Let's now practice on more problems. For day 1, provide an easy level programming coding interview problem, solve the programming problem with Python, and provide a detailed explanation, time complexity, and space complexity. Provide test cases to the code as well. This will make ChatGPT provide an easy level problem, solve it, and provide an explanation for the solution. I would encourage you to start with the easy problems for each section and work your way up to hard problems. The problem generated is super simple and it's telling us to find the largest number in a list. I would read the problem first and try to solve it on my own. After that, I would read the ChatGPT solution and explanation. I would also take a look at time and space complexity, since this is a very common question that gets asked in interviews after you finish coding. ChatGPT also provided some test cases, so it would be a good idea to test your code and make sure it's producing the correct output. To practice more on the same type and level of questions, we can tell it to provide another problem. This problem is very simple like the one before, and it's just summing up even numbers in a list. We can generate harder questions by copy-pasting our earlier prompt that produced our first practice question and change easy level to medium level. And voila, here's a harder problem. And of course, you can generate as much as you want. This problem is about finding the longest subarray that have an even sum. It also provides the problem, the solution, the explanation, and test cases. You can also generate hard level questions by copy-pasting the prompt above and change medium level to hard. The output is what you expect, a harder problem with its solution. Let's now see if ChatGPT can explain more challenging concepts. It's a good idea to copy-paste the plan that ChatGPT generated before so that it doesn't get confused when you tell it to plan for a certain day mentioned earlier in the plan. I copy-pasted ChatGPT's plan and told it to act as a teacher and explain all content for day 2, provide code samples when possible. As you can see, it had no problems tackling the content in day 2. It covered arrays, lists, stacks, queues, and graphs. It also provided code snippets for each. We can also ask it to generate practice questions like before. This time, it provided a question that is related to the content learned from day 2. This problem is a graph problem, and just like before, it provided the question, the solution, the code, and the explanation. Let's now tackle an advanced topic. For advanced topics, I would suggest you to utilize ChatGPT to create a separate study plan for this specific advanced topic with reading material. This will help you grasp more information clearly with less frustrations. It will also provide ChatGPT a structure to build on when explaining this concept. Let's tackle dynamic programming, for example. This is an advanced topic in problem solving. It gave you a breakdown of what you should learn, and it also listed some reading material. We can follow this up by telling it to explain what it just listed down. It started to explain dynamic programming concepts like memoization, top-down approach, and bottom-up approach. It also provided a couple of questions to explain dynamic programming on. It specifically showed us the Fibonacci problem and the knapsack problem. Let's say I didn't get the Fibonacci explanation. I can ask ChatGPT to explain it again and in more detail. Now it's better. It first solved the problem by using plain recursion and told us that this solution is a big O n power 2, which is inefficient. Then it adapted the code to include dynamic programming and explained how it did it. It also told us that now the code runs in big O n, which is way better than the previous solution. You can also keep asking it to explain it in different ways and to use different problems. This is one of my favorite things about ChatGPT's explanation. You can ask it any follow-up question or ask it to re-explain concepts, and it would do so like a very patient teacher. Lastly, let's say you're solving a question outside ChatGPT and you get stuck solving a question. All you have to do is copy-paste the question in ChatGPT and it will provide you the solution and explanation. Now, ain't this convenient? By following our tips and strategies, you'll be on your way to mastering coding interviews and impressing your potential employers. Remember, practice makes perfect, so make sure to put in the time and effort to prepare for your next technical interview. Thanks for tuning in.